Assalamu alaikum and a very good day to all of you. I am Ms. Atira and today we will be reading an opinion essay. Alright, opinion means pendapat, so an essay about what someone thinks. Now this is based on page 60 in your Pulse 2 textbook. Here are the things that we will do. First, we will read and listen to the text and then we will look at how two different opinions are written. Okay, how the author or the writer tells us his or her different opinions. Okay, and then last one, we will complete an exercise about identifying main ideas. Now first, let's read while listening to the text. We'll listen first, then I'll explain the meaning afterwards.
Unit 5. Writing. An opinion essay. Exercise 1.
Will people ever live on the moon? Many people like the idea of going on holiday to the moon. But will anyone actually live there in the future? Scientists have different opinions on this subject. On the one hand, the number of people on Earth is growing, and we are destroying our natural environment. If we aren't careful, one day we won't have any food or energy. If this happens, we will need to find a new place to live. On the other hand, the moon isn't a very comfortable place for human beings. There isn't any air or water, and the temperature is too hot or too cold. Maybe we will be able to improve conditions on the moon, but it will be very difficult. In conclusion, I don't think people will ever live on the moon. In my opinion, the Earth is a better place for human beings.
All right, now that we've listened, let me explain a bit in case some of you do not understand. Those of you who do, you can skip this part. Now, look at the title. Will people ever live on the moon? This is the title, okay? Tajuk dia pasal, adakah satu hari nanti people akan tinggal on the moon? Okay, so introduction, tengok. There are four paragraphs. Dia dah letak A, B, C, D. So, first paragraph talks about the introduction. Pengenalan dia, dia cakap apa? Many people like the idea of going on holiday to the moon. Like a lot of people like thinking of going on holiday. Okay, macam best je pergi holiday to the moon. But will anyone actually live there in the future? Adakah these people akan live there? Akan tinggal on the moon in the future? Dekat masa depan. Scientists have different opinions. It is so dia cakap scientists ada berbeza pendapat on this subject. On this subject maksudnya on this issue or on this topic. Okay, so tengok. Dia cakap, on the one hand, salah satunya pada satu sudut ataupun satu pendapat, the number of people on earth is growing. Okay, jumlah manusia dekat bumi ni is growing, is increasing, makin banyak. And we are destroying our natural environment. Kita sedang merosakkan alam sekitar. If we aren't careful, dia cakap, if you're not careful, one day, satu hari nanti, we won't have any food or energy. Our food, makanan kita, our energy, tenaga kita akan habis. Maksud tenaga dekat sini adalah like petroleum, tenaga electricity, those things, okay? And then dia cakap, if this happens, we will need to find a new place to live. Alamak, kalau jadi betul-betul, kita memang kena cari tempat lain lah untuk hidup, untuk tinggal. Okay, so itu adalah satu pendapat. Now, next, tengok exercise C. On the other hand, okay, manakala, on the other hand, manakala, satu pendapat lain pula, dia cakap, the moon isn't a very comfortable place for human beings. Dekat moon tak selesa, tak sesuai. Why? Because there isn't any air or water. Tak ada udara, tak ada air. And the temperature, suhu, boleh jadi too hot or too cold. Sangat panas ataupun sangat sejuk. And then dia cakap, maybe we will be able, mungkin we can, improve conditions on the moon. Mungkin kita boleh improve, menambah baik conditions, keadaan dekat moon tu. But it will be very difficult. But confirm susah lah dia cakap. Okay, then last kali, in conclusion, kesimpulannya, I don't think people will ever live on the moon. Saya tak rasa orang akan selamanya tinggal, orang akan tinggal on the moon. In my opinion, pada pendapat saya, the earth is a better place for human beings. Saya rasa bumi ni adalah tempat yang lebih baik untuk manusia. Okay, so we're done reading. Let's move on to the next part. Tengok, okay. Now this part is where we are going to focus on two different opinions. Dua pendapat yang berlainan. Now we use on the one hand and on the other hand untuk menunjukkan two different opinions. Okay, we use them at the beginning of paragraphs. Di permulaan perenggan. Okay, we use it at the beginning. And then, we use it to show clear contradiction of two opinions. Kita nak tunjuk contradiction. Maksudnya perbezaan yang ketara. Okay, clear contradiction. Perbezaan yang ketara antara two opinions. Dua pendapat. Okay, let's look at the example here. On the one hand, computers are already very intelligent. Okay, itu paragraf pertama. Yang kedua dia cakap, on the other hand, they haven't got feelings like human beings. Okay, nombor dia cakap, dari satu sudut, computers are already very intelligent. Computers ni sangat bijak. Okay, on the other hand, manakala dari satu sudut yang lain pula, they haven't got feelings like human beings. Mereka ni tak ada perasaan macam manusia. Okay, so if we translate in Malay, on the one hand dengan on the other hand ni boleh membawa maksud macam dari segi satu sudut, lepas tu manakala dari sudut yang lain pula. Dia macam tu, you faham tak? Sebab tu we use it at the beginning of paragraphs. So bila orang baca paragraph tu, orang tu faham, oh okay, ini adalah pendapat yang lain pula. That's it. Okay, so for example, dekat teks tadi yang kita baca, see, paragraph B and C we have on the one hand and the paragraph C on the other hand. So when we use this in our essay, tengok dia guna memang at the beginning of paragraphs, dekat permulaan setiap perenggan. Okay, and then this means these two are two different opinion. Dua pendapat yang berbeza. B cakap pasal lain. C cakap pasal lain. Okay, so that's it. Itu sahaja that you need to understand. Now, last one. Let's identify main ideas. This is exercise 3. Dia cakap, look at the essay again. In which paragraph does the writer... So, dia nak you cari paragraph mana sahaja. Okay, so nanti jawapan you akan jadi paragraph. Okay, so you write down paragraph blah blah blah. Berapa? 1, 2, A, B, C or D. Okay, let's look at the question. First one. Number one, give reasons why people probably won't live on the moon. Okay, give reasons why people will not live on the moon. Orang takkan tinggal dekat bulan. Okay, which paragraph? Number two, give reasons why people might live on the moon. Okay, reasons. Tadi reasons kenapa orang tak tinggal dekat bulan. Sekarang, kenapa reasons orang mungkin tinggal on the moon. Okay, number three, which paragraph does the writer give a personal opinion on the subject? Personal opinion, pendapat peribadi dia. A, B or C? Sorry, A, B, C or D? And last one, in which paragraph? That's the writer, ask a question. Okay, cari balik dekat mana. That's all very simple. All right. So we have read and listened to the paragraph, to the text, and then we looked at how two different opinions are formed. And last one, you only have to finish this exercise, exercise three, which is to identify main ideas, paragraph mana, this writer says, blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you for joining. Bye-bye.